Next weekend, you can sip, you can snack your way through 25 local restaurants and 30 different vineyards from across the nation, all in one spot. It's Minnesota Monthly's annual food and wine experience, and Megan Guess is here with a preview. You're marketing the event.
I am.
Always an awesome event.
It is.
What's going on this year?
Yes, so it's our 29th annual.
Wow, okay.
So it's aging just like a fine wine.
Nice.
As well.
Nice.
And it's happening next weekend, March 1st through the 3rd.
Cool.
At the Omni Viking Lakes Hotel down in Eagan.
It's always a great event. You guys do well.
Yeah, we have so many great restaurants, James Beard, award-winning chefs.
For sure.
We're super excited for the weekend.
All right, so one of the things people get to learn about wines there, the smell,
yes.
The look, the feel, what you like. You've devised a game for us. I'm excited to
get into it. I have, yes. So we're going to do a blind taste testing. I'm going to give each of you, we're going to kind of go down the row here.
Okay.
You can tell me what you smell, what you taste, and then I'll let you know what it is when we
see
get
how close
it.
We
so,
get?
Yeah.
I
right,
drink
so
a lot of wine, but this
grab
is
grab a glass. It's a perfect way to start
describe
the day.
Describe a lot. All right.
What do you smell?
Get in there, Ben.
It's all about the nose, right? It's more smell than taste, really.
All right. This is a grapefruity wine. This is obviously a rosé, right?
Yeah.
It is a rosé.
Okay, which is a mix between a little bit of red, a little bit of white.
Give it a taste.
Fruit forward, love it. He's swirling it around. Do we have a bucket that we can go?
It's rosé on point.
So,
the wine is sweet and dry. It's both.
Yes.
It's well aged, but it's a new rosé for the most part. A little sweeter than what I would like, but something that you could drink, say, around 8:51 in the morning.
Is that what time it is?
I think so, yeah.
It's perfect for that.
All right, so what's your guess?
Very sweet.
Rosé?
Yeah, rosé.
Okay, it's a rosé. What year?
Yeah. 2016.
Okay, I'm going to go 2020, and we think it's from Napa.
Oh, okay, you're close.
Okay,
so
is it
is a rosé. It is
rip
from
it off?
Stonehouse Cellars. Feel free to rip that off.
All right.
Like Stonehouse Cellars is in Lake County, California.
Lake County? Where's that?
And they will be there just north of Napa Valley.
Oh, just north of Napa.
Yep.
Okay.
So you're close?
Close. All right.
We're very close.
Rah!
You got it.
Oh, a Grenache rosé. Of course it was Grenache. Okay, good job.
We're going
to the next one.
All right, we're going to the next one.
All right, here we go.
Grab a glass.
We got 2 minutes to get through three wines.
All right,
sipping, Ben.
Smell, don't forget.
Oh, wow.
All
wow.
The senses.
Fruit, big fruit forward. Really sweet.
Yeah, citrus.
Smells like big citrus. No butter. I got no butter.
No butter, so it should be.
It's not a Chardonnay. Definitely not a Chardonnay.
There's a little Windex, harsh,
there's a little Windex in there. I think there's Windex. New tennis balls.
It's an interesting.
Yep. Definitely tennis balls. New shoe smell. Nikes.
Mm-hmm.
No, New Balance.
Adidas.
All right, I'm going to go
right,
with.
All right, any thoughts?
Oh, it's harsh. All right, I like, I don't know. It's not a Chardonnay. I think it's like a Sauv Blanc.
Mm-hmm. How about a Viognier?
It could be a Viognier. Okay.
Yeah.
I think it's Sauv Blanc. It's too crisp.
We've got a Sauv Blanc.
Hey, hold on. This one is from this Paso Robles.
It is not.
Oh, okay.
So this is from Cache Creek.
2021.
Cache Creek.
Cache Creek, Sauv Blanc.
2022.
That is also from Lake County, California.
Jeez, Lake County. Yep. Killing us. All right, we got to keep going.
Yep.
We got a minute left. All right, ready, Ben?
Here
it was good, by the way.
So, go.
Cheers.
Go.
All right.
This is definitely a red wine.
It is.
That's a Cabernet Sauvignon, hands down. It's good.
Velvety.
And it's really, okay. This one's got old pirate ship. This one has leather belt tobacco. This one's got a little raisin in it.
Mm.
This is Cab Sauv, this is Napa, and this is new. This is 2020, 2021.
All right, so this one's very exciting. So this is a wine from J.Lohr Wines.
It is
a cab.
Come on.
And J.Lohr is one of our presenting sponsors at the event. So they are celebrating their 50-year anniversary this year.
Let's go. Put it on
and
Instagram.
And they have created a 50-year anniversary version of this wine for us. And they'll
beautiful.
Be pouring.
Yeah. Last one. Ready?
Last one.
Oh, this is more raisins here.
Heavier, darker. Yep. He doesn't drink a whole lot of wine.
This is
the heavier tobacco taste.
Oh,
smell.
Yeah. That's big dog. Oh, no. That's a... I don't know what that is. Is that Mourvedre? No, this is Malbec. Could be. I'm going to say Pinot Noir. I'm going to go Pinot Noir or Zinfandel, but no, Pinot Noir.
Ben?
What do you got? I was going to guess Malbec.
This is also a Cabernet Sauvignon.
Oh my goodness, we got smoked on that one.
So we got two of those at the end.
Ooh.
So this is from Sol Rouge in Lake County, California.
That was fun. And you know what? You did great. And you did great.
Thank you.
That was so fun. See, Ben, who knew?
You can drink wine.
Who knew?
Yeah, who knew?
All right.
Yep.
I love this. We should do this every morning. I mean, on the weekends. The Food and Wine Experience is March 1st through 3rd. It's the Omni Viking, as you said, Lakes Hotel. It's in Eagan. That place is beautiful. Yep. Tickets are limited, though, so you got to get them while they're hot. Link is on care11.com if you want to learn a little bit more.
Cool.